Hello, my beautiful ladies. It's Greta here, ladies relationship coach. And today, my queens, I'm gonna share with you four ways on how to set up boundaries in a relationship. And actually, these boundaries you can also use with friends, family, or any other people you interact. So let's get on with it. The first way, which we can use with children a lot, and actually with dogs too. I know it sounds really funny, but not only you can use it with kids and dogs, you can also use it with guys in your relationship. And guys can use it with you too, obviously. So, reward the good behavior, ignore the bad. So there is one example that I like to share. And that is, you know, ladies, when you text a guy a message and that message is a bit edgy, it's not the nicest, it's not the kindest, maybe it's a bit provoking, it's a bit more on the negative side, what does he do? He reads it and he doesn't respond to it, right? Ladies, use the same tactic. When the guy is negative towards you, when he is going crazy, when he's nasty, when he's mean, or he's just pushing the buttons, if you didn't like his attitude, you ignore it. Don't acknowledge it, and in no way go crazy. Because if you are responding to his bad behavior, it shows how much you care and how much it's affecting you. And whenever he wants to see how much you care, make you go crazy, all he needs to do is be negative with you. So ladies, attention, positive or negative, it's still attention. It still shows how much you care. So if a guy sends you something nasty and you're responding to it, he's still getting rewarded for his bad behavior. So make sure not to respond to his bad behavior and make sure to appreciate the good one, because the more you appreciate the good behavior, the more you will get off the good behavior. The second tip would be, now ladies, sometimes ignoring the bad behavior does not work. The person keeps doing and doing and doing and doing and provoking, right? The idea behind ignoring is not that you're being submissive, not that you're okay with it, where a lot of girls tend to think. We go like, oh my God, Greta, but if I'm ignoring it, I'm telling him that I'm okay with it. No, you're not telling him that you're okay with it. You're telling him that I don't care about it. In other words, I don't care about you. When you ignore his bad behavior and you're not reacting, he's like, oh my God, why is she not reacting? Does she not care about me? Does she not have feelings for me? Right? See my point? Now that's why it works. And the other thing, what you could do to teach him a lesson is to mirror his behavior. Now, be careful with mirroring. You have to be very wary of it. The things that you could mirror is like, if he's pushing your buttons gently, then you can mirror him back gently. Don't overdo with things, for example, where he has done something nasty and now you're mirroring him. That's just digging yourself a hole, right? If you decide to mirror his behavior and give him a taste of his own medicine, I would recommend to mirror only things on a more gentle side. Like, do not play with fire. Better it's to ignore it. Or if it's really bad, then you leave the situation rather than mirroring or ignoring it. Now, as an additional point, I would like to, ladies, to look at the mirroring like this. Sometimes ignoring someone's bad behavior doesn't work, right? And in order for that person to get it and to respect you more, sometimes we need to mirror it. A good example would be when children are going to school and, for example, the boy is getting bullied and he's getting bullied and bullied and bullied and bullied, and he is ignoring it, right? He's ignoring it and he's picked on after and he's getting bullied, right? So in this case, if you're getting bullied for a long time because you're not standing up for yourself and because you're ignoring it, the bully, like a person who is a bully, we see nastiness and anger and losing emotional control as power. It's not power, but we see it as power. The reason it's not power is because you're exploding in every single way. You can see that person's reaction. You read them as an open book. An open book is never power, right? But anyway, sometimes this person sees it as power. So if you're ignoring their bad behavior, they start seeing you as weak. If they, you know, if you don't get the whole personal development stuff. So what do you do in this case? If you keep ignoring it and they seeing it as weak and they after you, what do? You punch back. Right? This is why it's good to teach some children to punch back. I'm not influencing it, you know, in any way, but you need to learn how to stand up for yourself. You know, same as with girls as well. I remember when I was playing basketball, I had this girl who was nagging and talking behind my back. When she got so brave, she started talking badly into my face, when she started gossiping around. And then one time she put me on a spot and she just went nasty on me, like on a spot, in front of like plenty other basketball players. And just because I choose to be nice, just because I choose to be good, it doesn't mean that I cannot be nasty and bad, right? It's a choice, right? Being nice, being good is a choice. But sometimes people see it as weakness, you know? So sometimes you need to go down on their level and give them a taste of their own medicine in order to respect you. So I kind of went a bit nasty on her in two sentences in front of everybody back. And since then, she's been like, as I say, running after my ass, praising me like crazy, like nearly admiring me, which I found totally bizarre. But anyway, what I'm saying is sometimes you need to stand up for yourself, because ignoring doesn't work with everybody. But do not use this in their relationships. The third way on how to set a healthy boundary in a relationship, ladies, do not escalate and provoke arguments. Also, do not respond to provocations. When the guy is provoking you with an argument, or he's being mean or rude or nasty, or he just set something off, see it as a red light and tell him ASAP, please don't talk to me this way, I did not like that. If he continues to disrespect you, do not get involved into the argument, just leave, right? Do not respond to negative attention. Do not create drama. Drama attracts more drama. If you touch a piece of shit, your finger starts to stink, right? Do not put your finger into drama. It's gonna be really hard to wash it off, all right? Just leave. When you leave like this, you tell him with your actions, if you're going to be mean or rude with me, I'm not going to stay with you. I'm not gonna be with you in the same room, because I have better things to do than that. But if he's rude or mean to you and you're screaming, crying, complaining, getting upset, nagging, taking his hair, punching him or any other crazy way you can think of, you're saying that whenever you're rude or mean, you're making me really upset, but I'm still gonna be here with you, all right? So if he's mean, you acknowledge it ASAP, you tell him, please don't talk to me this way, in a very calm, collected presence. And then if he continues this way, in a very calm, collected self, you leave, okay? So ladies, in this fourth way, I'm gonna share with you how to set the healthy boundaries with people, with friends, not just your guy. So if, for example, you're with a friend or you're in a circle of people where people are telling you what you don't like, or be picking on you, or be putting you down, right? And the best way is to ignore it. And then if something hits you, and if something hits you, if something does make you upset that your friend said or people said, it's good that it made you upset because now you know that it's your insecurity, right? Now what you can do, you can get aware of it, and now you can think on where it came from and what can you do to get rid of it. Also, just as a bonus, if somebody is being rude to you, if somebody is being mean to you, somebody is calling you names, don't take it personally. A smart person will never call the other person names. We will never gossip behind your back. We will never put you down. So if somebody is doing that, it's just because we're not as clever. So the best way to look at it, don't take it personally. Just kind of feel sorry for them. You know, because as person who is nice, who is kind, who is smart, who's empowering, we will never put the other person down. We will only lift them up. And guys, what I would like to leave this video is, heaven is strength, hell is weakness, all right? A lot of people see hell as strength. That's wrong. That doesn't make sense if you break it down. A lot of people see losing emotional control, going crazy, being angry, being aggressive, and so on. We see it as strength. That's not strength. That's weakness. Why is that weakness? Imagine the situation. Somebody done something to you, right? And let's say this person is, let's say heaven, this is hell, right? So this person is angry and this person is calm and collected, right? And somebody, let's say, has done something nasty to this person and to this person, exactly the same thing. Now, this person is losing emotional control. This person is going angry, aggressive, it's blaming others, you know, it's victimizing themselves, it's just going totally, totally crazy, right? So you're looking at this person going totally crazy and you start feeling sorry for them. You're thinking like, oh my God, they are crushed, right? When you look at this, how do you look at this person? You look like, oh my God, they are so weak, right? Because we're losing all the emotional control. Now, if somebody has done something to this person and this person is still staying calm and collected, you're looking at this person and you can't read them. You're looking at them and you're thinking, like, why are you staying so calm and collected? You know, like that person will make you wonder, because you will actually feel weak just by looking at this calm and collected person, because you're going to be intrigued. You will be, why are you not going crazy? Why I see so much strength in them? Why do they have another plan? Do they have another idea? Don't I know everything about this person? You see, so straight away you see here strength and here you see weakness. So guys, again, heaven is strength, hell is weakness. Negativity, drama, gossip, you know, losing emotional control, that's all weakness. Gratitude, kindness, going after your goals, dreams, ambitions, controlling the emotions, that's all strength, okay? Anyway, if you liked this video, please press like, subscribe to my YouTube channel, let me know what you learned. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Join my high value women group where we are all in the same boat learning how to be women of high value and bring out the best in our men. Follow me on Instagram. My Instagram is private. It's called Ladies Relationship Coach. I do Instagram lives for a couple times a week, a little bit randomly. And you can ask me questions during my Instagram lives. And if you would like me to hold your hand and help you to bring out the best in your guy, you can always book me through my website, which is called ladiesrelationshipcoach.com. And thank you so much for watching, queens. Have a beautiful day. Kisses from London. Mwah.